Good morning students and welcome back to Anand Prakash Educational Academy's video channel. I am Bhupesh Vansal, Director Anand Prakash Educational Academy and your Mentor for Physics. पिछले कई वर्षों से हम लोग फिजिकल एजुकेशन के माध्यम से कई बच्चों को कोच कर चुके हैं, मेंटरिंग कर चुके हैं. वो बच्चे आज अपने जीवन में एक सक्सेसफुल लाइफ की तरफ अग्रसर हैं. Many of them are profound engineers, most of them are doctors, they are working for multinationals, they are working for good companies, public sector undertakings, government sector. Some of them are working in the good hospitals, having their own clinics, and a majority of them are self-entrepreneurs. If you too want to be successful, you too want to walk on the path set by them, what you have to do? You have to follow our mentorship, you have to be disciplined, and rest, as our tagline goes, where success becomes your destiny. So success will definitely be your destiny. In class 10th we were studying the chapter of magnetism, and till now we have seen Fleming's right hand rule and the working of AC, working of motors with Fleming's left hand rule. Today we are going to start with alternating current and direct current again, which we have discussed already in the last video lecture, but we are going to discuss it today. Direct current or DC is a current where the current does not change its direction. I am again repeating, it does not change direction. In alternating current, it changes direction in equal periodicity. It changes direction in equal periodicity. That means, if for x seconds it is positive or current is in the positive direction, then for x seconds the current is in the negative direction, again goes back to positive, again comes back to negative, and the time interval remains the same, then only it is called alternating current. If it always remains positive or negative, it is the direct current. Now let us move on to the chapter of the day, or the syllabus which we have to cover in the day. That is, first part is working of a generator. As we have studied in case of motors also, let us take the similar example. Let us put a coil which can carry the current in a magnetic field. Let this be the north pole, this be the south pole, and this be supported in the center through a shaft. If I apply a clockwise rotation to it, that means now I am giving a mechanical force to the rotor. I call it as a rotor. The coil as a rotor. My magnetic field is in this direction. If I use my right hand rule, my magnetic field is in this direction. If I see here, the mechanical force here is inwards and here is outwards. So mechanical force is in this direction, current is flowing downwards. Here the current is flowing downwards. Let me see what is happening in this direction. Magnetic field here, force is outward, so current is flowing upward. Now again I apply slip ring here, but instead of single slip ring, now I use two slip rings. I connect this conductor to this slip ring and this conductor to this slip ring. Put carbon brush, one here and the other here, and put a galvanometer here. Now see what is happening. I'll again mark these points as A, A dash, B, B dash. In the first half of the rotation, when A, A dash is here, the current is moving through this conductor in this direction. When A, A dash is in its original position, The current flows from A dash to A, from A to the carbon brush, I'll mark say C and this carbon brush as D, to carbon brush C because I connected it to C, and from C to the galvanometer, that means the current in this is here. From galvanometer it goes to D, from D it gets connected to B and completes the loop. What happens after half a rotation when A comes here, A dash comes here, B comes here, B dash comes here, let's see. So first half of the rotation, my current was in this direction. Now second half of the rotation, in fact A current is flowing from A to A dash, not from A dash to A, and that means second half of the after half rotation the current changes its direction. Again after half rotation the current again changes its direction, so it becomes a sinusoidal wave. In fact I am showing you the squares, it is in the form of a sinusoidal wave like this. So this is the alternating current generator. In the alternating current generator we are using two slip rings. They are not slip rings like what we are used in case of motor. They are full slip rings and the two conductors are joined separately to those slip rings. Now what will happen if I use only one slip ring? Let us see that also. I will rub this part of the figure. If I use only one slip ring, then I have to use split slip ring. So this is connected here, this is connected here, this is a carbon brush C, this is a carbon brush D. Now let us see what is happening to the galvanometer. Now if you see, initially the current is flowing from A to H to A, through C it goes to galvanometer. That means here also direction of current is like this. After half a rotation, and if I continue further, the current is going to D, from D to A, A to A dash, so my loop is getting completed. So in the first half of the rotation my current is on this side. What happens after half a rotation, let us see. C moves here, D comes here, it's not C and D moving, it's the slip ring which is moving. So I'll just say the position of corresponding position of slip ring C and corresponding position of slip ring D. I have A here, A dash here. Again when I use Fleming's right hand rule, magnetic field is like this, force is outward, current is upwards. So current is in the upward direction. Now the current is flowing like this, moves like this from here, B dash to B, from carbon brush C, carbon brush remains C only, from carbon brush C it moves like here and it maintains the same path. Again if I continue doing it for every half rotation, then we find that the current is always in the same direction. It is not going from positive to negative. This type of arrangement is called a DC generator. And the arrangement with double slip ring is called a AC generator. So we have seen what is an AC generator, what is a DC generator. Students, so far in this chapter we have seen if a current carrying conductor is moved inside a magnetic field, it generates electricity. But if I move a magnetic field in a current carrying atmosphere, then also electricity is induced. The basic example we will take is a solenoid. A solenoid is a coil, and there is another coil here. Here we have a galvanometer and here we have a source. When we close this switch, what happens? The current starts flowing through this coil, and depending upon the direction of the coil winding, this pole suppose is the north pole, then this becomes the south pole. Because the core is common, this side becomes the south pole. So there is a magnetic field lines moving here like this. Because of movement of this magnetic lines, we get a deflection in this galvanometer, which shows that when magnetic field lines are introduced into an electrical circuit, it produces electricity. If I keep the switch closed and the magnetic field lines get stabilized, the galvanometer comes back to its original position. So it only happens when there is a change of state of magnetism. It is not that if the magnetic field lines are there continuously, because the state is not changing. जैसे कि हमने motion के time पे भी देखा था, जब हम move करके ऊपर खड़े कर देते हैं, तो magnetism या current flow नहीं करता है. It has to be moved continuously. So here also, if I continuously change the position of the current, then only there will be a deflection in the galvanometer. Otherwise, galvanometer will come back to its null position. Similarly, when I open this switch, there is a change in position of the magnetic lines. That means the magnetic lines vanish. At that time, I get a deflection in the other direction. This happens because of change of magnetic field lines. But what will happen if I use, instead of a DC source, suppose I use a AC source. Now AC is shown, AC is shown in a circuit like this. If I use a AC source, now we have seen in AC source, the source, the current is changing its direction continuously in this way. So when I close this switch, first time the current is moving like this, then the current is moving like this. That means initially it is the north pole, south pole in half a direction, and this becomes north, then this becomes north, south. So there is a continuous change of polarity of the magnet. Thereby, there is a continuous change of direction of the magnetic field lines. So this is continuously showing us deflection, once in the positive direction, the other time in the negative direction. That means if I use a AC source, I can use solenoid as a switch, or I can use solenoid to detect electricism, or for many, many other uses. So friends, this is as far as magnetism is concerned. We will be taking up questions on magnetism, but before that we will be taking up the next part of the lecture, that is domestic wiring. Domestic wiring we will be taking up in the next lecture, in which we will be talking about the phase, the neutral, the meters, the parallel connection of the house wiring, importance of the earth wire, why it is required, what are the safety precautions to be taken while dealing with electricity, and thereafter, after taking the questions on this chapter, because there are no numericals as such in this chapter, after taking a few questions on this chapter, we'll wind up with this chapter and proceed to the next chapter. Till then, enjoy the life. I know you are taking care of yourself, you are taking care of your family, you are avoiding playing outside even today. So keep it up, enjoy the life, be safe, and don't forget to like these videos and subscribe to the channel. Thank you very much.